brother has requested it. I had never made one before, and so I decided, well, let's go ahead and do it and show how you kind of make up a template and then you start making it based on your best guesses. Now, I did Pinterest this, and I think my owl is going to be about 10 to 12 inches high, and it's going to be sort of round, and it's going to be a great horned owl, so it's going to have things come up, and I want his head to come off because my brother wants a lid. It's going to be very colorful. So I'm starting out with just a slab, and I use my Shimko slab roller for that. My slab here is a quarter of an inch thick, just a quarter of an inch plus just a little bit, because it's going to be a little bit bigger, so I want it to have a little bit more substance. Usually my slabs are about half an inch wide. So I have my slab here, and I'm going to, this is the length of it, and this is the width of it that's going to curl around to be the owl's body. So I use this little tool, you can see it, to create my bevel so that when I connect my edges, I have a nice bond there using my vinegar mix. I use P5 clay, which is porcelain at 5/6 cone. I like it a lot. It doesn't have a lot of grog in it. It's beautiful for hand building. It's actually pretty good for proing as well. So I'm going to be, for something this size, I probably ought to be using this more acute angle than this one. But I really kind of like this one. It takes off less clay, so I'm going to be using that one instead. So I'm just going to go along. I hold it down. Let me move this down a little bit so that you guys can see what I'm doing. I hold it down, especially at the end here, because it pulls a little nibble of clay off the end. And I line it up, and I just go along the length of the clay. And this is where I hold it so it doesn't make that little nibble at the end. Now, oftentimes, I will have a little bowl, and I'm trying to find where that is right now. I put my clay pieces in it, put a little bit of water in the bottom, and then just put my clay pieces in it like that so that I can recycle them over time. Now, the bevel is going this way on this side, therefore I need to turn it over and make the bevel on the other side. So gently, I'm going to turn my clay over and bevel on the other side. I'm not going to do anything with the top and the bottom yet. Quite sure how I'm going to make the owl on the top and the bottom. I know how the bottom, but I don't know what I'm going to have to do for finishing on the top, so I'm not going to do that right now. Now, the next thing I do, and this will be it for this particular video, I use my trusty flamethrower. I've talked about this in a prior video. It's a regular propane tank, but up here, it's a Benzomatic TS-4000. I like this particular one because when you push the button, it's automatic. So you don't have to go turning knobs in different places in order to get this thing to go on. So I use the propane quite a lot in my pottery work because otherwise I don't have the patience to wait for things to dry, so I zap them. Oftentimes we'll have more than one thing going at a time, and therefore I'll zap this one, leave it, and then come back to it later when it dries a little bit more. Sometimes I'll turn it over also and use the propane torch on the other side as well. When it gets stiff enough, I'll come back and I'll do the rest of the video, or the next part of the video, where I actually make a cylinder out of it. Thanks, see you next time.